I wish. Along the banks of the River Arno in Italy, there's an old world city full of splendour. With its golden towers and many palaces, it looks like a fairyland. In this beautiful city called Florence lives little Francesca. She lives in a narrow house in a narrow street with her mama and papa and brother Nino. Francesca likes to go to the art gallery. There, among the beautiful paintings in gold frames, Francesca dreams about a wish that is close to her heart. It is a secret wish. Many artists from all over the world come to the gallery to make copies of the great masterpieces. The smallest pictures of all are painted by an American lady. Francesca never tires of watching the lady hidden under a big hat, and never, never does she get too close to the lady for fear of disturbing her. But to herself, Francesca whispers over and over again, "Oh, I wish I could have a painting all my own, just a little one to take home." One day, when Francesca was on her way to the gallery, thinking her secret thoughts, she tripped over a cat. "Oh, excuse me," she said, and went on. The cat followed her and kept getting between her feet all the time. Finally, Francesca stopped and bent down. Around the cat's neck was a locket on a ribbon. Now, there are lots of cats in Florence, but Francesca had never seen one wearing a locket. On the locket was a picture of a lady. "Oh, you lovely cat," Francesca said. "You must go home to your mistress." And she sent the cat off with a gentle push. Later that night, Francesca heard a sad cry out in the narrow street. She went to the window, and in the dark below was the strange cat meowing. Well, Francesca just had to let her in. The next morning, in one of Mama's baskets, lay the cat, and beside her was a tiny newborn kitten. Francesca still went every day to watch the American lady, but she always came home early so that she could play with the cats. Before long, the kitten's eyes were open and she was bouncing around after Francesca like a ball of fur. "Oh, I wish you belonged to me, you sweet little kitten."
"No, no," said Mama and Papa. "The cat belongs to the lady on the locket, and now the kitten belongs to her too. You must try to find the lady. That's the right thing to do." Francesca knew she must do the right thing, but she said to herself,
"I do not wish to find the mistress of the kitten, but I will try. I will."
The sisters at the convent said, "No, we have never seen this lady." The man with the wine cart said,
"No, I don't know her."
The flower lady said, "Ah, what a pity." Signor Tucci, who sells birds, said,
"You had better ask the policeman, Francesca."
The policeman had heard nothing of lost cats. Francesca's heart leapt. Maybe she could keep the lovely cats after all. She had tried, hadn't she? She would take them home now. That is what she would do. The next morning, Francesca hugged the kitten and stroked the cat, then ran to the gallery. She had missed a whole day. What if the American lady had gone away? No, the lady was there. Francesca crept slowly and softly towards the lady. Suddenly there was a great commotion at the entrance to the gallery. The lady turned. Francesca gasped. There were the guards racing about trying to catch the cat and the kitten. They had followed Francesca. The kitten licked Francesca's ankle with her rough little tongue, but the mother cat sprang right up into the lady's lap. She had belonged to the American lady all along. It was a glorious reunion. Only Francesca was sad. She was going to miss the little kitten. When the lady could catch her breath, she said to Francesca, "You have made me very happy. Will you help me carry the cats home?" Francesca followed the lady to a big hotel, up in the lift, into the lady's room. The lady went over to the easel, saying, "A little kitten should belong to a little girl. And in case you lose her, here is a little painting to hang round her neck." And that's how Francesca's wishes both came true. With her very own picture and her very own kitten, Francesca felt like a fairy tale princess as she skipped happily home to her narrow house in the narrow street in the beautiful city of Florence.